Good morning, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is Santos Capellan Jr. Saying good morning and wishing you a good day. Okay, now today, as I promised in my previous video, that I will try to discuss about motor control. Okay, now again, if you are new to my channel, please subscribe and click the notification bell. Now, okay, without further ado, let me begin with the motor control. Okay, now, as you can see, I have here two small motors. Okay, in my previous video, control schematic for fresh air fan and exhaust air fan, I said in that video that as a BMS engineer, you should be able to understand how motor control is being designed, how a motor control or MCC is being wired. Okay, how it's being wired and designed. Okay, now this is a small motor control. As I said, if there is a motor, there should be a motor control. Okay, now how are you going to design or fabricate your motor control? Now, first, in front of this enclosure, you should be able to give some information pertaining to the motor being controlled. Okay, now what I have here are some pilot lamps or some lamp indication. Okay, so I have here fan run status, and this one is intended for fan trip status, then fan to run status, then fan trip status. Okay, so we can say that this is for fresh air fan, and this could be for exhaust air fan. Okay, so I'm designing, let's say I'm designing a motor control controlling both fans, but basically it is a best engineering practice that there is one motor control for each equipment. But for just explaining it to you or some demonstration, I will just show you one motor control that controls two equipment. Okay, now, as I said, there should be some lamp or pilot lamp indication so that you will know what is the status of those equipment. Okay, now what else? I have here this one, as you can see, it is already lit. This one is intended for power on, meaning there is already power in the motor control. Okay, now I have here a selector switch. Selector switch, it is hand off auto. Okay, now your equipment should be working in a manual or hand position. Okay, so if you put it in hand, you should be able to start it and stop it. Okay, now if you put it in automatic, as I said again, as you can see, this control is already working because there is already previous programming. I use this one for teaching my students. Now as you can see, when I put it in automatic, the program loaded in these controllers are already working. Okay, so you put it in automatic, it will run. Okay, okay. So I guess this one, this is already programmed of one of my students. Okay, now as I said, there should be a selector switch. When it is in hand, the operator or the technician can push that start push button so that it will work. Okay, so when it is in automatic, as I said, when the equipment is in automatic, that's the only time you can or your BMS can control it. Okay, so since there are two fans, okay, so when I put it in automatic, both fans are running, as you can see here, because there is already program written on the one of these DDC controller. Okay, now you can see here also, I am here push button switch. Okay, so during manual operation, I can start and stop the fans. Okay, now in my next video, what I'm going to do is I will show you how these things are wired inside. Okay, so basically, this is the idea of motor control. Again, if there's a motor, there should be a motor control. Okay, now I think this is enough for this video. Thank you very much for watching my YouTube channel, and I hope I was able to give you an idea about motor control, what is the typical components in the motor control. Okay, so once again, thank you very much for watching this short video clip. If you are new to my channel, please subscribe, And you can press, you can click also the notification bell so you will be notified when there is a new video. Thank you very much. Bye for now.